'Cause the old house once knew my two, and this old house once knew my wife. This old house was home and comfort as we fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter, this old house heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the night wind walks about. Ain't I gonna need this house no longer, ain't I gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time
to fix the shingles,
ain't got time
to fix the floor.
Ain't got time
to oil the hinges,
nor to mend the
window pane.
Ain't I gonna need this house no longer, I'm getting ready to stay.
This old house is a-gettin' shaky, this old house is a-gettin' old. This old house lets in the rain, and this old house lets in the cold. Off my knees I'm a-gettin' chilly, but I feel no fear of pain. 'Cause I see an angel peekin' through a broken window pane. Ain't they gonna need this house no longer, ain't they gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time
to fix the shingles,
ain't got time
to fix the floor.
Ain't got time
to oil the hinges,
nor to mend the window pane.
Ain't they gonna need this house no longer, I'm gettin' ready to be the same. Now my old hound dog lies asleep and he don't know I'm gonna leave. Else he'd wake up by the fireplace and he'd sit there and howl and grieve. But my hunting day's over, I ain't gonna hunt the coon no more. Gable's hunting down in the chat when the wind blew down the door. I ain't gonna need this house no longer, I ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time
to fix the shingles,
ain't got time
to fix the floor.
Ain't got time
to oil the hinges,
nor to mend the window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Ryman Auditorium in Music City, USA, Nashville, Tennessee, for the final farewell celebration of one of America's most beloved quartets, the Cathedrals. Featuring the Cathedrals, Ernie Haas, Scott Fowler, Roger Bennett, Glenn Payne, and George Younts. And featuring some of their very special friends, including the Oak Ridge Boys, the Stadler Brothers, Sandy Patty, Bill Gaither, Jake Hess, James Blackwood, Guy Penrod, and many more. Stick around for a very special evening you'll not soon forget.
Why not? And welcome to the historic Ryman Auditorium, where we're here tonight to celebrate 40 faithful years in the field of gospel music with the classic Cathedrals. Welcome them, ladies and gentlemen, the Cathedrals.
Yeah. Once I was sinking in sin, my soul was troubled within. A ladder was sent down to heaven after my sins were forgiven. Started out for higher ground,
they climbed the ladder
round by round.
Well, I'm
climbing higher and higher, and I won't come down.
The first round was regeneration,
still climbing.
The second,
justification.
Still climbing.
The third, a happy confession.
Still climbing.
And then the Holy Ghost took possession.
Still climbing.
The next round was great tribulation.
Still climbing.
Did your soul a glorification.
Still climbing.
Well, happy climbing high.
Welcome.
The sun, moon, and stars, Jupiter, Venus, Neptune, and Mars. I'll bid farewell to this whole house of clay, and then we'll go running up the Milky White Way.
First to heaven,
I'm climbing round my round.
Second heaven,
I'm so high, I'll never come down.
What a thrill for us, ladies and gentlemen, when TNN said they would do this for us in Gaither. We said we were thrilled, and we said we'd like to have some people that we loved here, and man, did they ever do that. I look at all the audience here, all these people, we can call them by your first name, and you just overwhelm us with your hospitality. Thank you for coming. From the bottom of our heart, thank you for coming, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate that. Hannah, and are you glad to see the old man again playing? I got to tell you this. His wife, and since he's here tonight, his wife invited some people over for the last part of the week a couple of weeks ago. She invited them the first of the week for the last part of the week. Well, in the middle of the week, she started feeling bad. And she's going to her house saying, maybe I should have waited. Maybe I shouldn't have. Maybe I should call them, tell them not to come. Well, she didn't call. They came at the end of the week. About 15 of them sat down for dinner. And how was Marla?
She's 7 years old.
So they asked Marla to pray. She leaned over to Glenn. She said, what will I say? Glenn said, just say what your grandma says. She bowed her head and said, dear Lord, why did I invite these people over here? Here, I want you to listen to a song a little bit different than anything we'll do tonight. Roger Bennett wrote this song in 1978.
I was about to give up on it.
He finally got enough money to have us record it. You know?
That's not a joke.
Here, I love this song. That Day at Calvary.
In the Garden of Gethsemane, he shed great drops of agony. He prayed, Father, if it be thy will, let this bitter cup pass from me.
Hey, I'll do the low note, you lay off it.
For it was God's will for him to go and die on Calvary. The pain that he bore, the blood that he shed was for me.
That day at Calvary,
it changed my history.
It changed my history.
Gave me a new outlook on life.
Now I can conquer the sin and the strife the devil threw at me.
The devil threw at me.
This journey. when my life was still held in sin's bondage. I had a great fear of things that I couldn't understand.
I'm gonna slap you.
But when I came to know the fabulous love of my Jesus, He banished my fears and firmly took hold of my hand. That day at Calvary,
it
changed my history.
It changed my history.
Gave me a new outlook on life.
Now I can conquer the sin and the strife. The devil throws at me.
Walked in the house the other day and she said, "Honey, I think there's water in the carburetor." And Glenn said, "Water in the carburetor?" I said, "You don't know the carburetor from the steering wheel. Where's the car?" She said, "In the swimming pool." After 55 years of traveling singing, the old man singing better right now than he ever had in his life. He's incredible. Glenn and I are so proud of these young men.
I hate young people. Don't talk to me.
Somebody get it. Yeah. When he wakes up, there's no telling what he might say. This is incredible. I've been out here 53 years and 55 for Glenn, and we've never sung the same song for 9 years in a row. Well, Ernie Haas, are you glad to see Ernie Haas, our tenor singer? Ernie is from Evansville, Indiana, and Ernie is, in fact, the first Sunday he sang with us, we sang at the Cathedral of Tomorrow in Akron, Ohio. He had never seen my daughters, they had never seen him. He saw my third daughter, Lisa. Lisa saw him, lightning's flashed, thunder's rolled. They got married 6 months later. Ernie is my son-in-law, you know. Bass singer shouldn't have a tenor singer for a son. No. I'm still having fun. No. How old are you, Ernie?
34.
34 years old. I got food in the refrigerator older than that. You know? Ernie walked on stage with us 9 years ago, sang this song. We have sung it every time that we've sung in the last 9 years. An incredible tenor singer sang an incredible song. Oh, what a savior.
Valley, no hope.
and they found a Savior to save a poor lost soul.
Whatever you got on your heart, share with us right now, would you?
I'm just blown away. I am singing with my favorite group, the Cathedrals. I have been here 10 years, and I used to go and hear them to sing when they came to my hometown. And it was just a dream of mine to be able to sing with these guys. I get asked all the time now that I've been here so long, you know, how do you get in the business? I'm sure most of you sitting out there have been asked that if you're in the business. And I always tell them it's a calling. It really is. You have to be called. And I knew when I was 12 years old that I was called to be in this business. I lived in southern Indiana, and back behind my house was just acres of cornfield. And on the other side of that cornfield was a nursing home. Every Wednesday, I would take my guitar back there, and I'd gather all those elderly people together in one room, and I would lead them in choruses. I'd sing hymns to them, like, "When the Roll Is Called Up Yonder, I'll Be There," "Amazing Grace," "I'll Fly Away." And so it was then, at the age of 12, I knew not only had God called me to sing gospel music, but He had called me to sing with old people.
set me up. I like it already.
Jesus said, I believe him. Life will be sweeter someday.
I'm gonna trust him,
never doubt him. No matter what the folks may say, can't turn away from him lightly.
Because the joys of heaven I'll miss, for I will
live on the glory after a while.
Don't you know I'm gonna
sing with the angels above.
I'm gonna talk
to the ones that I love.
I'm gonna tell him about my troubles.
After a while,
well, I'm gonna march
down the streets of pure gold.
Hey.
Talk to the prophets of old,
and I'll be happy.
I think he wants to play one. Okay. All right, go ahead and play some.
You know what? We're still early in the evening here. If I need your help from now on, I'll ask for it. That was a piano solo, not a harmonica solo, and I hope you get a fever blister.
Well, I couldn't help it, Roger. It was a calling on my life just at that very moment.
I mentioned a moment ago about us asking how people that we love and people that love us to. And many, many years ago, God allowed our paths to cross with these boys right here. To think that they would take time out of their schedule to come and be with us overwhelmed us to start with. And then the friendship, could I tell you this? I wasn't going to, but most of you know about my kidney failure. And the bass singer with this group call the other day, and he said, George, I've talked it over with my wife. Cleveland Clinic is a world-class place, and I'll come, and I got two great kidneys, George. I'll come, and I'll give you one of my kidneys. And I just burst out crying. I said, Harold, I'm too high a risk because of my heart for a kidney transplant. But I never had anybody say anything as kind and nice to me as that. And nobody has ever come along like these guys out here. Would you welcome our buddies, the Statler Brothers?
Window in the sky and said,
I created man, but I don't remember why. Nothing but fighting since creation day. I'll send a little water and I'll wash them all away.
So the Lord came down to look around a spell, and there he found Noah behaving mighty well. That is the reason the scripts record, Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason the scripts record, Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
The Lord said,
Noah, there's going to be a flood. There's going to be some water. There's going to be some mud. Take off your hat, Noah. Take off your coat. Get Ham, Shem, Japheth. Build yourself a boat.
Noah said,
Lord, I don't believe I could.
The Lord said,
Noah, get some sturdy gopher wood. You never know what you can do till you try. Build a 50 cubits wide, 30 cubits high.
Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason that scripture quoted. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Noah said,
there it is, Lord.
The Lord said,
Noah, it's time to get aboard. Now take a creature, a he and a she, and of course, visit Noah and the whole family.
Noah said,
Lord, it's getting mighty dark.
The Lord said,
Noah, get these creatures in the ark.
Noah said,
Lord, it's beginning to pour.
The Lord said,
Noah, hurry up, shut the door.
Noah had grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah had grace in the eyes of the Lord. That is the reason this scripture roared. Noah had grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah had grace in the eyes of the Lord.
Well, the ark rose up on the foot of the deep, and after 40 days, Mr. Noah took a peek, said,
we ain't moving, Lord. Where are we at?
The Lord said,
sitting on Mount Ararat.
Then Noah said,
Lord, it's getting mighty dry.
The Lord said,
Noah, see my rainbow in the sky. Take all the creatures and people to earth. Don't be more trouble than you're worth.
Noah find grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah find grace in the eyes of the Lord. Noah find grace in the eyes of the Lord. And he landed high and dry. And he landed high and dry. And he landed high.
That fat. How'd you keep your teeth in?
Well, we didn't have any polygrip. Glenn was out. We found something sticky in William Lee Golden's beard, and we used that. But it worked.
But it worked.
Yes, it did.
Man, what is it? Jimmy, watch Ernie over there, because Ernie, when you hit that high note, Ernie turned to me and said, I'm going to kill him and tell God he died. You know?
He don't have nothing to worry about.
Boys, what an honor, what a thrill to be here. You know how much we love you, don't you?
And we love you, too.
I appreciate that. Hey, could you, before Harold has to go back to bed.
It won't be long now, man.
Could you do one other song for us?
We'd love to.
Thank you, boys.
Thank you.
Palms of his hands. There were thorns in his brow, and only God could know how much pain he could
all around the hillside as a mother mourned her loss, and we all stood to gain from the heavenly pain on the other side of the cross.
On the other side of the cross, the side that no one could see, hung the spirit of things yet to come, hung the future of you and me.
And what he gave that day on the cross, not one bit of love has been lost. Hold my hand, stand up and say, if you were there on that day, on the other side of the cross,
on the other side of the cross,
the Statlers.
Glenn and George, I wonder what I could say. Well, let's take Glenn first. He and I have been friends since 1947. That's something like 52 years, I think. And, of course, George, the first time you meet him, you feel like you've known him forever. And we just about go that far back, too. If any two guys in our business deserve to do well, it's those two guys. God bless you.
You know, I used to go by Bill Gaither's house years ago, and since he's not in the old folks' home yet, Bill, come here. We'd gather around the piano, and Bill would pitch us some songs, and some of them we liked, and some of them we didn't. No.
Well, that always happened after Gloria Fedjian. She is a great cook.
You know
right?
What? We'd go by, and Gloria would cook dinner for all of us. Hey, Gloria's a great cook. You ought to go by there and eat sometime. Tell them the Cathedral sent you.
Tell them George sent you.
But I thought since you were here in this segment, we've sung so many of your wonderful songs, Bill, that if you wouldn't mind, and I don't want to put you on the spot. Yeah, I do. I love putting you on the spot. You know, you don't know what's going to happen to you. I want you to come over here to the piano with us, and we're going to sing some of your songs. And
I'm just going to listen, okay?
Some of them we know, some of them we don't know. So when I miss the words, you just boom, boom for me, would you? Let's start out with this then.
Jesus, 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 there's just something about that name.
Must be saved.
I can remember the day they came by, and we had just written this song, And I said, George, I think we got a song just for you. Story song. Sing it. Would you?
Today I went back to the place where I used to go. Today I saw that same old crowd I knew before. When they asked me what had happened, I tried to tell them,
thanks to Calvary,
I don't come here anymore.
Thanks to Calvary,
I am not the man that I used to be.
Thanks to Calvary,
things are different than before. While the tears ran down my face, I tried to tell them,
thanks to Calvary,
the house where we used to live. My little boy ran and hid behind the door. And I said, son, oh, little boy, don't be afraid, because you've got a brand new daddy now.
Thanks to Calvary,
we don't live here.
That's right.
And more.
Thanks to Calvary,
I am not the dad that I used to be.
Thanks to Calvary,
things are different.
Joe, while the tears ran down my face, I tried to tell my little boy. I said, son, thanks to Calvary.
Thanks to Calvary,
we don't live here. Thank God, we don't live here anymore.
Beautiful. Bill. The song has meant so much to me down through the years. The very first day that you had me sing it, it's been a special song in my life. You know what? While you're here, I said I wasn't going to put you on the spot. There's another song that we do, and would you do a verse of it? I'll feed you the words. Going home. And you sing the first verse, and I'll do the last verse.
You wrote it. You ought to know it.
Listen.
Many times in my childhood, we traveled so far. By nightfall, how weary I'd grow. Father's arms would slip round me. Gently he'd say, my son, we're going
sing with us, would you?
Now and then you write a song specifically for a person. This song, Gloria and I did write this one after hearing your testimony, George. And on the very best day that we have, a lot of people come up and say a lot of exciting things about what our music is doing for them. And we're thankful for that. That's very encouraging. But down deep, we know what we are.
Yes.
If you could see where we've come from, what God has brought us through, and especially hearing George's testimony, Gloria and I wrote this song at our very best, on our very best day. We're still just an old sinner.
Saved by grace.
Saved by grace. So sing it. Can I slip down here?
Yes.
If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I know you would see the miracle of love that took me in its sweet embrace and made me what I am today. Just an old sinner saved by grace.
I'm just a sinner saved. He took my place.
with each breath of life I take.
I'm loved and forgiven, back with the living. I'm just a sinner, save my grace.
How could I boast of anything that I have ever seen or done? How could I dare to claim as mine the victories God has won? Where would I be had God not brought me gently to this place? I'm here to say I'm nothing but an old sinner saved by grace. I'm just a sinner, yeah, saved by grace. Oh, and I stood condemned to death.
George Johnson, Glenn Payne, for a long, long time. First time I met Glenn, he was going to the Stamp School of Music in Dallas, Texas, and we were broadcasting from Shreveport at the time. You know, I think to make a real good quartet, you have to have a good lead singer and a good bass singer. Of course, I'm a lead singer, so I would feel that way. But they are very essential to a good quartet, and when I heard the Cathedrals, they had a good lead singer and a good bass singer. And they are retiring again, like kind of like I am. But I wish them all success and congratulations on many, many years of singing great gospel music.
Yeah. Makes you want a boogie, don't it?
I'm standing by the river.
was over on the other side, other side.
Standing on the banks of the river, looking beyond, looking beyond
the river.
Standing on the banks of the river, looking for a home, looking for a home
to heaven.
Just to get a glimpse of my Jesus into that home up there on high. Looking for the light of my Savior up in the sky, up in the sky.
Standing,
I'm standing by the river, even wide and high.
Gazing,
I'm gazing,
raging,
mighty, raging, mighty, mighty.
I'm standing,
I'm standing by the river, trying to get against it what's over on the other side, other side.
Standing there waiting for the boatman, ready to go.
Ready to go
to heaven.
Standing there waiting for the boatman on of that shore, on of that shore. When I see the lights of that city and behold my Savior there,
then I'll know forever I'll be in my Savior's care.
Well, I was standing on the banks when I saw the little ship take my mama home. I was standing on the banks when Daddy crossed the river and left me all alone. I'm standing on the banks just waiting for my ride to heaven's golden shore. And I'm
trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side, other side.
Standing by the river, even wide and high.
I'm
a gazing
across the
mighty river.
Trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other.
Trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other.
Trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other.
Trying to get a glimpse of what's over on the other side.
I'm standing by the river deep and wide, and I am gazing.
I'm gazing.
Hey, but there's so many wonderful things we could say about the cathedral. They said we could say anything we wanted to about them, anything serious or funny. And quite frankly, I can't think of anything serious to say about it.
I'll tell you, when you start talking about Ernie and Scott and Roger and the old one and the funny looking one.
Yeah, we are. Which one's the funny looking one?
Well, I don't know which one do you think's the old one. They are absolutely some of the we've been in the business so many years, and I can honestly say of all the people we've known, we're probably as close to them. They're some of the best friends we've got in the business, and we certainly admire them. Well, they are just absolutely the greatest.
Years ago, God allowed our pastor cross for these next young men, and that saying again, no friends like old friends, and these guys have kept in touch with us down through the years, and you know how busy they are. And when they found out we was going to do this, and we asked them to come, they dropped whatever they was doing and said, "We're going to come for our old friends." Would you welcome the incredible Oak Ridge Boys?
I'll tell you how we really came to be here tonight, George. We didn't come to sing. We're going to sing a song, but we didn't plan on singing. What happened was I was listening to gospel radio station on the way to the bus, the Nashville 104 gospel, the solid gospel 104. Got to keep up with those quartets, you know, and those good old family groups that are singing today. And I was on my way to the bus one night, and Glenn Payne was on, I think, with Jim Black and a few people on the air. Gary McSpadden, right, Gary was on the air. And I was listening on the way to the bus and listening to the quartet sing, and Glenn said that you guys weren't going to be singing anymore after this year. We go way back. I was 15 when I first met you.
I know that.
15. Dwayne Allen back here knew that today was my birthday as we taped this thing tonight. And
it's your birthday.
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Oh, stop it, George.
Happy birthday
George.
To you.
George.
Happy birthday, little Joey. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, George. Dwayne Allen come to me on the bus about 2 weeks ago and says, boy, have I got a birthday present for you. I said, what? He said, on May the 18th, right smack on your birthday, the Cathedrals are singing. And he knew that I've been talking for weeks and weeks since I heard Glenn on the radio, because I was afraid this year might go by and we may not get to see you again sing. And that's why we're here tonight, to hear you sing, to hear the greatest quartet that's ever been. The greatest.
When you just got your license, you drove from Philadelphia down to, was it Reading?
It was actually Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Yeah, I had just got my license, and I loaded up a bunch of Pepsi and potato chips in the car, and my daddy had just had a debilitating stroke, and had he not had that stroke, probably wouldn't have let me take this trip. I drove to see the Cathedral Quartet. I got there, the opening group was done, don't even remember who they were. I ran down there, ran down the aisle of McCaskey High School in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. The Cathedral Quartet came out, it was Mac Taunton singing the tenor, Danny Coker, and you and Glenn. You had on white pants and green sport coats.
And we thought we was tough, didn't we?
Yeah. And you came out there on stage, and Danny Coker said something about singing about Jesus passing by and hoping that he passed by as you sang. And you sang, since Jesus passed by, oh, what a difference since Jesus passed by. Never forget it, George. Oh, I've never forgot it my whole life.
Oh, bless you, buddy.
And I have to admit, those pants were kind of funny, George.
Pardon?
Those white pants were kind of funny, as I recall. Let's sing one for the boys.
Life is like a mountain railroad.
Oh, yeah.
With an engineer that's brave, we must make the run successful from the cradle to the grave. Watch the curves, the hills of tunnels, never falter, never fail. Keep your hand upon the throttle and your eye upon the rail.
Yeah.
Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore, where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forevermore. As you roll across the trestle,
oh boys, that's good,
spanning Jordan's swelling tide, you'll behold the Union Depot, into which your train will glide. There you'll meet the superintendent, God the Father, God the Son. With extended hands he'll greet you, weary pilgrim, welcome home. Blessed Savior,
Lord, thou wilt guide us.
Grant it, Lord.
Till we reach that blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forever.
I don't know of anybody in the gospel music field who's had the impact that George and Glenn and the Cathedrals have had. Their consistency, their wonderful quality of music that they've always insisted on, and their faithfulness is one of a kind. And what a way for them to go out. They went out at their very, very best.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, greater than all my sin. How shall my tongue describe it? Where shall his praise begin? Taking away my burden, setting my spirit free. For the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful the matchless grace of Jesus. Deeper than the mighty rolling sea, unearthed grace, like a fountain, all sufficient grace for even me. Broader than the scope of my transgression,
sing it.
Greater far than all my sin and shame. Oh, magnify the precious name of Jesus. Praise His name. Wonderful grace of Jesus, reaching the most defiled by his transforming power, making him God's dear child, purchasing peace and heaven for all eternity, and the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful the matchless grace of Jesus, deeper than the mighty rolling sea, higher than the mountain, sparkling like a fountain, all-sufficient grace for even me.
For even me.
Broader than the scope of my transgression, greater far than all my sin and shame. Oh, magnify the precious name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus, wonderful name of Jesus, magnify His holy name.
Bless your heart. You know, we're better than I thought we were. Every time I turn around and look at him, I think of something.
I think about a lot of things, and I look around at you, too.
Glenn's brother Ken, said he, when he's going to school, he fell in love with his fourth grade school teacher. We was talking about how ridiculous that was. He was 11 years older than she was. Somebody asked me the other night and said, why do you pick on Glenn like you do? I said, God has called me to do this. At the praise gathering in Annapolis one time, there's a lady come. She's about Glenn's age. She's about 90. But I was wearing Glenn. Bill remembers. I was wearing Glenn out that night, you know. And finally, she stood up and shook her cane at me, and she said, "All the time, the last 40 years I've been seeing you fellas, you tease Glenn over and over. You tease Glenn. You ought not to do that. You ought not to tease him like that." And she raked me over the coals good for teasing Glenn. I had a terrible time explaining to her that I'm not teasing. Hey, should I tell them about New York?
No.
I got to tell you this. He went to New York City on vacation here a few weeks ago. And the lady who lived beside him, I'm going to tell it. The lady who lived beside him heard he was going. She came over to the house and said, "Glenn, my son went to New York City 8 years ago. I haven't heard a word from him." She, Mrs. Dunn is her name. And she said, "His name is John Dunn. When you get to New York, look him up and tell him to call his mama." And Glenn said, "Okay." Big place like New York, and he was going to find him right away. Glenn said, "Okay, I'll look him up." So he flew into New York, got in the cab, went downtown. Sure enough, when he got to town, the big brick wall had a big sign that said Dunn and Bradstreet. He thought, "I found him right away. You know, how lucky." He walked in the building, the girl sitting at the desk, he walked up to her and said, "Do you have a John in here?" And she said, "Right through that door." He went through, and there's a guy coming out of a stall, and Glenn said, "Are you done?" And he said, "Yes." And Glenn said, "Call your mama. Call your mama." I love old people. They'll kill you. Could I tell them one more thing before we...
You shared enough already.
We were in... They invited us to Denver, Colorado here a few years ago to sing for the... the
National Booksellers.
Yeah, National Booksellers. And they had never had a group like us. They usually have contemporary groups. That year they had us 2 days. After the Wednesday night concert, we had all day to kill. And Glenn and I don't go to movies.
No, we don't.
But there's a Walt Disney movie playing called 101 Dalmatians. We'd heard our kids talk about seeing that movie. So we was walking around town. I saw them. I said, "Glenn, let's go in and watch that movie 3 or 4 times a day, and we won't wear ourselves out walking around town." Glenn said, "Okay." So we went in, acted in a movie, sat down. It got dark. No sooner it got dark, Glenn was on his hands and knees in between the seats scratching around. I was a little embarrassed. I said, "Glenn, what are you doing down there?" He said, "I'm looking for a piece of caramel candy." I said, "Glenn, you don't want it. It's been on the floor." He said, "My teeth are in it." Somebody asked me how old he was. I said, "When he was a little boy, the Big Dipper was just a cup, you know." I guess it was 15, 16 years ago, maybe even a little longer, but Bill and Gloria had invited us to the praise gathering in Indianapolis, and 10,000 people. And we've been quartetting all of our lives and hadn't run into many soloists back in those days. And so that night, we were sitting in the audience, and Bill Gaither introduced a young lady, and she went up and sang. And Glenn and I looked at each other, and we said, "We've never heard a voice like that." And we became one of her biggest fans. And down through the years, I still say, "I've never heard a voice like this." Would you welcome Miss Sandy Petty?
Gonna know all about it, and farther along we're gonna understand why. Come on and cheer up, my brother. Living the sunshine, and then we
oh, to Sandy Patty. Let me strut over here.
Whew, what I would give for a vestal hanky now. Whew, it is just my privilege, gentlemen, to be here.
Thank you so much.
It truly is. It really is.
Bless you, dear.
I agree with something Joe said earlier. There is no finer quartet that has been or ever will be than you guys. The crowds have lined the narrow street to see this man from Galilee. He's just a carpenter, some say, and he's leading fools astray. Yet many kneel to give him praise, and in his eyes they glimpse the power that sees the hearts of all men. And he knows his Father's mind. He speaks his Father's words, for he comes in the name of the Lord. And then depend on you and the power of your name. And as we call upon your name, your strength through our weakness to show, we can know the Master's plan. We can extend hand when we come in the name of the Lord. And there is strength in the name of the Lord.
Singing with Glenn Payne is truly an experience. He is a joy to sing with. He's a real cheerleader. He pulls the lyric out of you, and it's wonderful.
My soul in sad exile was out of life's sea, so burdened with sin and disarray, till I heard a sweet voice saying, make me your choice, and I entered the heaven of grace.
Taking hold of the word, my fetters fell off, and I anchored my soul. The haven of rest is my Lord.
If you had to put some a quartet in a capsule and send it into the future, and to let other people know what a quartet should be and should sound like, it would be the Cathedrals. And they don't just sing it, they feel it.
They sure do. And that way, 75 years from now, when they open the capsule, they could make other people feel just as bad as they do us now.
Yeah.
Just as inferior.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? I want to introduce to you, in this corner, of the good and the right stands a champion robed in white. His height exceeds the heavens, his weight outweighs the world, his reach reaches everywhere, his age is evermore. He is
higher than the highest, greater than the great. No one will ever take his crown away.
He is more mighty than the mightiest. He reigns full of this arena to raise his hands in victory for me. But then an angry crowd, they crucified this king who wore their crown, and they gladly watched the champion going down. But I will never count him out, for I am a witness of the day he arose to retain his title, the champion of love.
He is higher than the highest, greater than the great. No one will ever take his crown.
And he reigns
from above.
Thank you.
fondest memories of my childhood were woven around supper time, when Mom would come to the back steps of the old home place. She'd say, "George, come on in, it's supper time." Oh my, but how I'd love to hear that once more. But you know, for me, time has woven the realization of a truth that is even more thrilling. And that's when the Lord comes to the portals of glory and says to come on in for supper time. And we'll be gathered around the table for the Lord himself at the greatest supper time of them all. In visions now, I see her standing yonder, and her familiar voice I hear once more. The banquet table's ready up in heaven. Ah, it's supper time upon the golden shore. Come home, come home, it's supper time. The shadows deepen fast. Come home, come home, it's supper time. We're got a lot more days behind me than I have ahead of me, and I know that. But I also know this: should he return tonight, I'm packed and ready to go. Got my house all in order. Got my house all in order. Oh, I'm going home. Yeah, for allowing me to sing a song that means so much to me. Glenn, before you go, come here. In fact, come here. Some people ask me and Glenn once in a while, why do you two old men sit down once in a while? I said, because we want to. We don't stand up as long as we used to, do we, Glenn?
We don't do nothing as long as we used to. What are you talking about?
Ask and you shall receive, you know. Here I am crying and snotting again, Glenn.
You could have said mucus or something or another.
my, what a, you know, 55 years for Glenn, 53 years for me, and December the 9th, 10th, and 11th in Akron, Ohio will be our last three concerts, and we don't even think about it from concert to concert because...
Can't.
We'd never get through it. We really wouldn't. So we push it back in our minds.
It's emotional.
It is an emotional time for us. And so many people have.
Right. But you know what?
What?
I already got my application in.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to be a Walmart greeter.
You, here's your cart. Let me know what Walmart. I'm going to wear you out, amen. And in talking about reminiscing, let me tell you one other thing. Just reminiscing the other day, and when Glenn and I, Bill, when Glenn and I first learned to shave, we were talking about this. We learned to shave with big, long, straight razor, big, long handle, big, long, straight razor. You lather up and learn to shave. Glenn said when he was about 15 years old, Golden, he was lathered up one July morning in Texas and getting ready to shave for the very first time, and a fly lit on the end of his nose. And he had that razor in his hand, and he forgot and took a swarp at it. And he chopped a little piece of his nose off, you know. He said when he did that, he dropped the razor and he was barefooted and chopped a little piece of his big toe off. He said he grabbed his nose and his toes up and run to the doctor, and they sewed him on the wrong place, his nose on his toes and his toes on his nose. He said ever since then, everything has smelled so footy. He said he had to take his shoe off to sneeze.
You bad.
I love old people, I really do. About 35 years ago, we was in New Orleans, Louisiana, one Sunday afternoon, and a lady hollered out the audience for us to sing this song, and the group we had back then didn't know the song.
We wore out several groups. That's the truth.
Every time he talks, I think of something. He's bad to forget. He really is.
Well, I am.
And he's the first to admit it. Jimmy, last year we went on a California tour. 26 days was gone. And while he was gone, his wife was moving into a new house. And she said, Glenn, when you come back, don't go to the old place, you know. We'll be moved. Glenn said, oh, how could I forget, you know. You want to add it? No, I remember. We was gone 26 days. He come back to the old house, you know. Tried to get in the door was locked. Looked through the window, all the furniture was gone. He scratched his head and went and sat on the porch, curb rather, and a little girl coming down the sidewalk on a bicycle. He said, honey, the people who used to live there, do you know where they moved to? She said, come on, Daddy, Mama said you'd forget, you know. But, a lady hollered out of the audience for us to sing this song, and I said, Glenn, I'll do the melody, and you pick out a harmony part. In a loudmouth, ungodly, vile, vulgar, crime-filled world, where we're seeing things we never dreamed we'd see,
right.
Hearing things we never dreamed we'd hear. Tanya, look at the television sometime, and my heart bleeds, and I'm sure you're all like I am. And you feel so helpless at what's going on, the pain of those people. And you say, man, the world's out of control. No, God still has everything under control. How long has it been since you asked the Lord to search you? Listen.
Search me, oh God.
Thank you.
as thousands were fed. And he touched the blind eyes, healed broken spirits. Amen. He moved with even raised up the dead. Once on a hillside, people were gathered, watching as he was crucified. No one showed mercy to the one who had healed them. And he died. Once on a hillside, people were gathered. Oh, Jesus had risen, amen, and soon would ascend.
Everybody gonna be happy over there, over there.
We will be happy over there.
We will shout and sing the same thing.
Everybody will be happy over there.
Everybody gonna be happy over there, over there.
We will be happy over there.
We will shout and sing the same thing.
Everybody,
Richard.
Patty. How about Bill Gator? Where's he at?